So you're managing a team, you're all using ClickUp, things are going pretty well, but the estimations of workload and capacity and just managing business in general gets thrown off when people are on vacation. If you are struggling with that situation of managing vacation time in ClickUp, you are not alone. And in this video, I'm going to talk through the four-step setup that I use to manage vacation time very simply inside ClickUp. Step one of the process to organize vacation time is actually just to figure out what your process is. What steps need to happen for someone to go from, I would like time off, to, all right, see ya. Like, what do you need to have happen in that window? Whatever it is, I would suggest turning that into a task template. You can have the option to make it a task with a bunch of custom fields, a task with a bunch of checklists, a task with a bunch of subtasks. I don't care how you structure it. And if you're stuck on that, you can watch this video for tips on how to structure it. But just make sure that all of your steps are outlined there based on your own unique business workflows. Once you're done with that, save that task as a template called vacation time processing or something like that. Once you have your vacation time process in a task template saved into the ClickUp template center, then we can go ahead and start using that template. The way I would suggest doing that is step two, creating a form. The form we're going to create is going to be very simple, collecting basic information about what is going on with this person's vacation. Whose vacation time is it? How long is it? What type of request is it? That kind of stuff. Every time a form is submitted, it'll create a task in a given list in ClickUp. So we also need to make sure this form is in a list called vacation time. Once we have those two pieces set up, we can also incorporate our template we created in step one. So right in the form editing window that you can see here, we can ensure that every single time this form is submitted, a template is also applied. And you guessed it, it's gonna be our vacation processing template. So now whenever I submit this form, it'll automatically create a task with my whole process automatically included from step one in a vacation list or vacation management list, whatever you wanna call it, to manage time off. Step three of this process is going to be notifying the person requesting time off that their request has been approved. This might have been part of the checklist or whatever it was that you created earlier on. If so, that is totally fine. If you didn't include this step though, we want to make sure we include it now. One of the most common ways to solve this is whenever a certain custom field changes or a certain task is complete, maybe one like this, whenever I click the approve box, it shoots off an email to somebody to let them know that their request has been approved. It could also happen directly in task comments, up to you how you'd like to structure that, but somehow, whether it's manually or automatic, we want to tell the person that their time off has been approved. That is step three so far out of our four-step vacation process. Now, before we go to the fourth step about capacity management with this vacation time stuff, I want to remind you to like and subscribe this video. It may feel like a small action, but it really helps this video perform better in the YouTube algorithm, and I would really appreciate it. Now, the fourth step here is going to be making sure that these time off requests are reflected in our capacity defense system. If you're not familiar with capacity defense, I talk about it in this video here a little bit. It's something we teach inside our course of deciding how you're going to defend the time of your people and plan what work you're committing to. And when it comes to planning work, we usually pick some kind of unit to do it. When it comes to capacity defense and measuring the amount of work, the most common ways to do it are by using units of time, effort, like points or something like that, or by using the number of tasks itself. Whatever method you use, we want to make sure that our vacation time task has that same method added in there as a time filler. So for example, if you use time as your primary unit of tracking how much work someone is doing, we want to put the time estimate or time tracked on this vacation task to block off that same amount of time. So we would add 8 hours and maybe we'd add the label of vacation into this block. So that way, when you're looking at the overview of what has Susie done this week or this month, we see this vacation block taking up 8 hours of time. So you know that yes, she still worked a full amount of time, but 8 of those were vacation and, you know, they're non-negotiable. If you don't use something like time that is easily, you know, put in there just to block things off, the second option here would be to actually just block off a window of time on a calendar. Very often, if someone doesn't use points or hours or something like that, they still use a calendar to coordinate meetings or other things. So what we could do is put a start and an end date on this task here, have it show up in a public view that our team sees, or have it sync out to our team's Google Calendar and use that calendar to keep track of who's taking vacation time when. The important thing is that we have one central source of truth when it comes to team members' availability. Doesn't necessarily matter how you do it, but this one task that we created with all of the data would be a very good piece of data to use in order to create that central schedule, whether that is a calendar view or syncing out to Google Calendar or blocking off time artificially using tagged time estimates or points or something else. So in summary, those are the four steps we want to go through to organize vacation time in ClickUp. We want to create our process. We want to collect the time. We want to review and notify the results of the time review, you know, the approval or not of the time off. And then we want to make sure that we have some kind of unit, whether it's a calendar date, time estimate, points, something like that, to keep track of this time off when we're actually planning our work for a given period. I hope this is a helpful video for you as you're trying to figure out how to manage vacation time inside ClickUp. If you have your own tips as to this process, I would love to hear it in the comments below. We'll be back here again soon with another video about how to organize your processes and ClickUp. And until then, enjoy the process.